am here with Jim and Linda from Mighty Peace Coffee. And I thought it would be kind of cool to start off with maybe you guys just describing a little bit about what Mighty Peace is and what you guys are all about.
So my name is Jim, Mighty Peace Coffee Managing Partner. We were founded in September 2018. And we say social impact because that's really what drove the founding of Mighty Peace Coffee. We were looking for ways to use coffee as a vehicle to bring peace in a post-conflict zone in Congo. And I'm a Congolese immigrant. That's really what drove me in the beginning. And really, my partner, one of the co-founders, JD, he was a filmmaker, and he had produced a film about supply chain transparency in the mining sector called When Elephants Fight. And that film got some great traction. Again, it was on Netflix, it's on Amazon and Apple TV now. And that film really called out big tech companies about their lack of supply chain transparency and lack of fair compensation to miners in Congo who really power all their products. My MacBook right now, you know, my phone, a lot of them have material that come from Congo. So that documentary really exposed lack of supply chain transparency and asked, you know, what the roles those companies can play in changing that paradigm, making sure that they don't contribute to chaos. So the film got good feedback in America, but the feedback in Congo was, your lobbying on our behalf is great, but we need jobs. What will help us more than this activism and filmmaking is you helping us find buyers for our coffee in America. We have great coffee next to all these mines, but people are afraid of Congo because of all the stories they hear about us. So can you help us find buyers? So again, JD shared that story with me. And, you know, as a Congolese immigrant, always looking for a way to use my privilege of being in America and being Congolese, how can I really, you know, use that to my advantage to create jobs in Congo and bring joy to Americans? And coffee was a great vehicle for that, because again, people love coffee and Congolese coffee is good. So that's really how we came to be. Yeah, what we try to do again is really to support Congolese coffee sector, because we think it'd be a great catalyst for long-term peace in that region, but also to support American coffee roasters who are looking for something new and exciting and looking to work with partners that are serious about the impact at origin. I think transparency, impact are trendy marketing words, but I think when people like talk to us more than once and see our work in Congo, they can see that we really mean it. It's sincere. It's really what drives the company. And we're really grateful that roasters give us a chance and that we're able to bring value on both sides of the Atlantic in America and in Congo. And the reason why we're able to exist really is because of we have a team on the ground led by Linda. And Linda's in Congo in Bukavu, and her work as an agronomy engineer, chief quality officer, and now licensed Q grader, like those relationships she has in the coffee sector, even before Mighty Peace Coffee, is what enables us to identify the coffee cooperatives we can work with, help us improve their coffee quality, help us build those relationships. And because it's on the ground, we're able to operate and continue to improve the quality of the coffee we bring year in and year out, because we have a leadership in Congo. And I think that's what really has enabled us to grow, because we have somebody in Congo we trust that is also an owner of the company that helps us get to where we are.
The first reason that we started working with you, you reached out because you saw that we were carrying another Congolese coffee. You sent us some samples and we, you know, roasted up samples, cupped them without going in with a lot of expectations necessarily. And the quality was just really mind-blowing, just really, really absolutely wonderful, terrific coffees. And obviously a big kind of step up from other area coffees I tried. So I'd love to know a little bit more about what kind of care and work you guys are putting into it, and kind of why are your coffees so much better than other ones that I've tried?
Cool. So I think that's a great question for Linda, since she's responsible for it really as a quality team member on the ground. Linda, do you want to explain why our Twende and Umoja's has been so good?
En fait, les cafés congolais ont une particularité là que peut-être on ne saurait pas expliquer, mais avec le temps, on est en train d'apprendre que ces cafés ont une particularité, je ne saurais pas vraiment dire, mais ce qu'on sait, c'est que aussi longtemps que nous avons un climat qui nous favorise cette culture, nous avons de pratiques agricoles qui soutiennent en fait la qualité et la quantité en fait. On fait bien ce qu'on fait et puis, nos gens sur le terrain, nos producteurs, ils sont motivés par des gens comme nous, par exemple, qui essaient de faire valoir leur travail à l'étranger, comme par exemple aux États-Unis. Et pour nous, c'est d'abord un plus, en fait. C'est un truc qui met vraiment en valeur le produit, je veux dire le café, en fait, leur produit qui est le café actuellement. Et le travail, en fait, ils mettent beaucoup de temps pour travailler... afin de maintenir La qualité, elle est là, mais il faut la maintenir et l'améliorer, en fait. D'où il y a des pratiques agricoles que nous, agronomes, nous dispensons aux petits producteurs et nous faisons de visites sur terrain pour voir s'ils ont pratiqué ce qu'on a demandé. Nous faisons des suivis, en fait. Et après, nous faisons des tests au laboratoire, par exemple, pour la dégustation. Et on essaie quand même de vous envoyer ou de vendre, si je peux le dire, le meilleur, en fait. Le meilleur.
You guys are working in cooperatives, kind of forming these boutique micro lots from coffees within those cooperatives. How do you pick a co-op? And then within that co-op, how are you selecting which coffees are going towards the specific micro lot? What's that process look like?
Je suis chanceuse d'avoir commencé avant Mighty Peace, d'avoir commencé dans un projet de café, en fait. Et grâce à ce projet, je faisais un stage et tout. On était en contact avec différentes coopératives de la région du Kivu, du Sud Kivu et du Nord Kivu. Et grâce à ça, ça m'a permis de renforcer les relations parce que j'étais dégustatrice à l'époque et je dégustais le café de ces différentes coopératives. Je faisais de formation ou de... Ouais, je faisais de formation, des dégustations et tout. Cela m'a permis d'entrer vraiment en contact avec pas mal de coopératives de la place. Du coup, Mighty Peace est venu. Et moi, en fonction de mon expérience, j'ai essayé d'orienter Mighty Peace auprès des coopératives fiables. Mais cela n'exclut pas le fait qu'on peut donner la chance aux coopératives naissantes, jeunes, et qui font du bon café et qui sont en train de se développer petit à petit. C'est grâce à ça que j'essaie d'orienter nos partenaires Mighty vers les coopératives que je connais personnellement et qui ont de l'expérience dans le domaine et qui ont de bons témoignages ici et ailleurs. Je suis sûre que Mighty Peace se renseigne sur telle ou telle coopérative et je suis sûre qu'ils ont de feedback vraiment positif face aux coopératives auxquelles je les oriente, quoi.
Kind of circling back to talking about working with the co-ops, you were talking about how soil health was something that you focus on a lot. Are there any mistakes or are there things that farmers tend to overlook when it comes to soil health that are things you frequently educate on?
Oui, ça manquerait pas. Vous savez, on apprend tous les jours. Moi-même, j'apprends et eux aussi, ils apprennent en fait tous les jours. Il y a toujours des défis à relever. Je dirais que s'ils ont besoin de ces formations, c'est parce qu'ils savent qu'ils ne sont pas aussi compétents et qu'ils peuvent s'améliorer grâce à nos formations. Nous aussi, on se forme ailleurs et on vient le former à leur tour. Donc, il n'y a pas moment de souci. Ils nous posent des questions dans la formation. Tu peux voir un producteur me demander ceci ou cela. Je dis, non, mais j'ai eu la chance, en fait, je m'excuse, j'ai fait l'agronomie. Et j'ai quand même une idée avancée sur la culture, sur beaucoup de cultures. Et les cafés aussi fait partie, en fait. Et ils peuvent demander pourquoi ce sol il est comme ça. Qu'est-ce qu'on peut faire? Il y a de pratiques. On peut faire le paillage. On peut amender les sols. On peut apporter de matière organique pour booster la qualité du sol afin que ça puisse aussi rendre meilleure la qualité du café. En fait, il y a beaucoup de défis et c'est pour cela qu'ils ont besoin de formation. Donc, on essaie de faire avec, mais la nature nous a tellement offert que il y a certains problèmes qui se résolvent par la nature, en fait. Mais sinon, on essaie vraiment de donner, de partager ce que nous savons auprès de ces gens-là pour qu'ils fournissent, que ce soit non seulement à Mighty Peace et aux autres acheteurs, un bon café. Comme ça, le Congo sera aussi connu dans ce secteur-là.
Because, for example, some of the coffee trees are old. You said that the biggest thing when it comes to soil health is just helping them understand, besides planting new coffee trees, what else can we do to really rejuvenate the soil and basically increase nutrients as a way to kind of revitalize maybe older plants and trees. So it's really about, you know, how to feed the soil really is really what it comes down to. So what people like Linda do is really help them understand the science behind it and why it has to be consistent. It's not like a one-time thing.
It seems like you guys are so intentional about how you approach narrative and a lot of the word choices you use And it sounds like a lot of what you're trying to do is kind of reshape perceptions. I guess, could you just talk a little bit more about how much thought and intentionality goes behind that?
The narrative is very important, like especially when you think about some of the team members having a, you know, filmmaking background. We understand the power of stories to really change perception and really shift behavior, whether it's, you know, making people be more transparent in mining. Like people see that, you know, Congolese coffee is a great coffee as well, that it exists. So it's something we care truly about the images and the words we use. Even the images, I think a lot of times photography and video, when it comes to farming, it's, I don't want to say it's demeaning, but it almost gives you, like, you're saving people at origin. But, you know, I'm from the origin, you know what I mean? I don't need to be saved. You just find an opportunity. So it's really just that approach of making sure that we represent people in a dignified way. We don't want to sugarcoat things, but we want to be honest without being demeaning or destroying one side of the story. So we're very careful about that, the words we use, the photos we take, and the videos we share, just because we know everything contributes to how people see Congo, see us, and we want to make sure that we put our best foot forward. So we're very intentional about that. And I'm glad you noticed it.
Cool. Well, I think that's a great spot to end. Yeah, we love all the thought you guys put in a narrative. We love all the thought that you put into selecting coffees and how you work with the co-ops. And I think it shows through really clearly with the end product. The coffee's super amazing. And yeah, we love working with you guys and excited to keep this thing rolling for sure.
Thank you so much, Ben. It's great working with you and Kathy as well. Really appreciate working with you guys.
Awesome. Cool. Well, I think that's a good spot to leave it. So we'll see y'all later and let's do this again.
Sounds good. Take care.
All right. Bye.